Hey guys, it's Meg. If you are new here, welcome to the channel. If you are a returning viewer, then welcome back. I don't really know what I want to talk about today. Honestly, there's a few things that's in my mind, but I just don't have it cohesive at the moment, so you're probably going to get a lot of verbal diarrhea in this video. But I just really wanted to sit down, play with makeup, talk to you guys. I just feel like you're my friends. Friends do that, right? Like, you call each other up with nonsense. Anyways, I guess one of the things that I wanted to talk about would be the blog that I've just launched. So if you follow me on Instagram, you probably would already know this, but I did start a blog called The Granny Lifestyle, and I'll talk a little bit more about that. Along with launching the blog, it's actually linked, or I have it in the description box down below. But alongside that, blog is an Instagram account, which I just also started, and it's also called The Granny Lifestyle, which is also in the description box down below. So it is essentially my life and what I do with it, because I'm the kind of person who likes to be in bed by 10 p.m. and would wake up as soon as the sun is up, regardless of how late I slept the night before. Now, if that resonates with you, you might like this blog. I'm also the kind of person who is often called boring, mainly because I don't like to party. I don't like to be in crowded places with loud music, surrounded by sweaty bodies that wriggle like they are having seizures. That's not what I like. When I think of girls' night out, I think of a quiet dinner with my small circle of friends, or maybe a hot chocolate and almond croissant in a cafe, talking about life in general and pondering the events that are happening around us. Yeah, things like that. That's who I am. I don't do club crawling and bar hopping because I like to be able to leave by 9 p.m. so that I can be in bed by 10 p.m. That's me. So if this is something that resonates with you, if you are someone who really prefers the simpler life and is really spending long weekends with Netflix and chill kind of person instead of being out and about, laying on the beach and getting a tan, then maybe we can be friends. Yeah, so I've only just started. I've posted the first blog entry today, which is probably a week later when you're seeing this. But yeah, so I've posted that, and let me know your thoughts and what kind of a granny you are, if you are one, and why you think you are. Like, what are the stuff that you do that makes you think that you're a granny? Because I've listed a few things on that blog entry that I feel makes me a granny, so I'd like to hear your thoughts as well, and let's brainstorm, okay? The second thing that I wanted to talk about, and is probably one of the questions that I get most of the time here in Australia, especially when I get into taxis or when I meet people for the first time, is where is my accent from? And a lot of people think that I grew up in the States, that I sound American. Now, I don't know if my American subscribers would agree to that, but that's just what I've been told. So yeah, especially when I get onto taxis and the taxi driver is a little bit chatty and they want to like have a conversation and they hear my accent, they're like, oh, your accent isn't Australian, whereabouts are you from? And most of them would guess correctly that I'm from the Philippines, but a lot of them would think, I would say perhaps 9 out of 10 of the ones that I've spoken to or met for the first time would think that I have, that I grew up in the States, and I didn't. To be honest with you, I've never set foot in America. Not once. I've left the Philippines for the first time when I was 25 years old. Right? The first 25 years, the first quarter of my life was spent growing up and being raised in the Philippines. I was born, raised, educated in the Philippines. I've never been anywhere else until I was 25. And the first place that I went to was in the Middle East, in Qatar. Okay, now my sister does live in Illinois, in the States, but I've never had the chance to visit her. That's one of the things that I would like to do. It's in my bucket list, is to do actually a cross-country drive from east to west or west to east in America, just so I can see the nice sights. Okay, but I've never been, so it's surprising to me that people would think that I have an American accent. So, and I always explain to them, well, it's probably because the education system in the Philippines is patterned after the American education system, and to be honest, the medium of teaching, of education in the Philippines is English. If I remember correctly, there were only two subjects that were taught in our mother tongue in Filipino, and that is the Filipino language, which everybody has to learn, and history. Everything else, like science, math, Christian living, because I was educated in a Catholic school. What else? PE, music, everything, home economics, it's done in English. Our books are in English. So yeah, I guess so. And I remember when I was young, I think I was probably 5 or 6 years old, I had a playmate who lived across the street from us. He was 1 year younger than me. And I remember my brother, who's 2 years older than me, we always used to like compete with each other and sort of like had a little bit of a sibling rivalry when we were younger. And I remember him asking, well, if you're so smart, then what is the English of Ibis? And I was like, I don't know. And this kid who was in primary school, who was like in nursery school actually, said cockroach. And I was like, what? How do you know that? And he said it in such a way that it kind of felt like I should have known it, like it was common knowledge, but I didn't know. So from that day on, I vowed that I was gonna stop watching the Filipino kiddie program called Batibot, and that I was just gonna watch Sesame Street. And that's exactly what I did. I watched Sesame Street, I watched a lot of English shows, and I have four older siblings, and particularly my eldest brother, he is a fan of American shows. Like, I grew up with Star Trek, MacGyver, Friends, what else did I grow up with? There were a lot of shows, Beverly Hills 90210, the original ones that had Jenny Garth, Jason Priestley, Luke Perry, who else was in it? Tori Spelling and Shannon Doherty. Yeah, I grew up with that. I grew up with Charmed. I grew up with Buffy. I grew up with a lot of American shows, which is probably where I picked up the accent. Because I remember sometime in high school, I think I was in my senior year, and I went to another school, and we were talking, and one of them said, you have an accent. And I'm like, this is how I talk. And I said, and you have the same accent. I don't know. I think it's that. Well, the Americans, when they came to the Philippines for the first time after the Spaniards left, brought education to us. The Spaniards brought Christianity. The Americans brought education. So that's their contribution to our history. I'm not going to go into the nitty-gritty of it, because there's a lot of controversy and a lot of pain behind that transition. I'll leave it at that. But yeah, they brought the education system to us, which is why we've got elementary school, junior high school, senior high school, and university or college. When we say we're going off to college, it doesn't necessarily mean it's college. It could be uni, it could be vocational school. It's general tertiary education is referred to as college in the Philippines. So yeah, that's where my accent is from, I guess. But yeah, one of the things that I really want to do eventually is to do a cross country in the Philippines, in America. So if you are from the States, tell me which state in the United States you are from, what your state is famous for, and what I should see if I ever happen to pass by your state. Okay, let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you very much. And if you would be so kind as to subscribe and hit that bell button so that you are notified of my, what do you call this? Oh, my video uploads, as well as be so kind and give some love to the blog and to my new Instagram account. It's all in the description bar down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next video.